Hello everyone and welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm. Now this is going to have a bit of a special place in my heart because the original Life is Strange is the first game I played on this channel and I loved it to bits. I put off playing the prequel, I guess this is, for a while because A, I wasn't sure if it would live up to it, and B, I just wanted a bit of a distance, but we've had that distance now, it's been a while. And Life is Strange 2 got announced very recently for late September, so I figured now would be the perfect time to do the prequel and then Captain Spirit, that little one-shot thing they released. So we will start here, see where it takes us. Only three main episodes and then the bonus episode, which, don't worry, I'll be doing the bonus episode too. But for now, let's jump in and see what Life is Strange Before the Storm has in store for us. I'm genuinely properly excited about this. It's a nice change of pace as well after the insanity, shall we say, of Dark Souls. Get back to my narrative adventure roots. Story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. I'm pretty sure that's like almost exactly what it said at the start of the original as well. Is this going to be Chloe? Pretty sure we play as Chloe instead of Max in this one. I don't know if Max is even in it, really. Aside from probably the farewell episode, I'm pretty sure that'll be Max. Well, that is an interesting way to get your kicks. Oh. Well, she looks pretty different here to how we're used to seeing her.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Indeed.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Fuck to the yes. Oh, no, we ain't going that way. I've got to check behind me. It has to be done. Right, so, what can we do? We can open our journal. Max. Actually, there's a lot of stuff. So you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up. And it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being the dead dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figure this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Pris from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and that smolder of his, but then Pris just totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. I think I just want her bangs. Chloe the Electric Sheep. You don't just want her bangs, Chloe, as we find out in the original. So is this... Oh no, this is after. Dear Max, Dad got me this stationery one day when I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down. And tonight I thought, hey... Maybe it's time to write Max. The funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months, despite all my calls and texts and... Not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck. There's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe, the unfriended. Oh, that's sad, of course. Yeah, I forgot that Max moved back right at the start of Life is Strange, and she'd been sort of airing Chloe. Max. Now this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten all about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max and you'll just live here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. Chloe, the journal boss. Ready? So Mum suggests taking a road trip next summer and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David, the wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mum and has stuck around like a bad zit. David the moustache monster from Planet Dipshit, that fucking David. Anyway, I politely suggested to Mum that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then, or breathing. Hey, shit happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues, and I've got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. She can do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like, I'm the asshole. Chloe. The asshole. Nice. Chloe, obviously... We're not going to read all of the little bios. We know roughly where she's at in her life, just from what we know from previous things. I don't think I know who William is. Do I know who William is? If I had a nickel bag for every jerk-off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write shit about Dad over the last couple of years, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again. I guess that they think it helps me cope with my feelings or whatever, as if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably still plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. And what the fuck am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad who was always fun to be around and never angry? That he treated me like an equal? That he was constantly working to make our lives better? That he could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch? That he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy? And that his barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again are both so painful that it's easier for Mum and me just to pretend neither of us notices it? If that's coping, then coping can go fuck itself. Shit. And we know about them, obviously. Mum and dickhead. It turned out to be alright in the end. Cool. Okay. Apologies if you did not want to hear that. I'm sure you've probably seen the game before.
No trespassing? No way.
I want to get into it. I want to be into the story. Hey, wanker.
Holy shit.
Looks like a decent party going on.
This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Nice. Okay. Do 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 do.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
And then leaving town.
You're always blaming everyone else but yourself.
Those guys need to get a room. Or not.
Oh.
Damn.
Mind your own business.
Don't have to tell me twice. Bye-bye.
I understand, really. This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Can I go around the other side? I can. Dun, 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 dun.
Now what to draw?
I thought she was gonna bust out the spray cans. I've just finished rewatching Breaking Bad, so this is perfect.
Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
One of my American friends, we were talking about best TV shows, and I was like, obviously, Breaking Bad is one of the best, if not the best TV show ever made. And she was like, yeah, never seen it. And I was like, you fucking what? And then we proceeded to watch all of Breaking Bad in about 2 weeks.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
We went in hard on the viewing there.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
I think that is pretty badass. Sup, boys?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
Starting off with, you gotta let me in.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here.
Doesn't do you any favors. Well, I guess we're finding a different way in then. Because there's no way we ain't getting in here.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around...
Get your rave on!
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
Is there anything I can do with these? Maybe not. Ponder.
Mom would totally flip her shit.
If she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. I didn't expect it to cut out the dialogue when I exited out there. Can you help me? No, okay. What about train car?
An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Can we get through anywhere here? No, it doesn't look like it. Okay, so... should we just talk to him again?
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Let me inside now. You've started a backtalk challenge, okay.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
I mean, I don't think that's how bouncers work, but sure. You can use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want, okay?
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Brutal. To succeed, pay attention to what your opponent says. Bedtime. Then pick a comeback that reflects their words back at them. Your bedtime, no bedtime.
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Again, listen to your opponent's words. Before the timer runs out. Okay, I don't do cute. Cute is relative.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonja riding a panzer tank.
Who the fuck's Red Sonja?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Sometimes the right choices are more difficult to pick out. Here, playground is a good response to kid.
Maybe I am a kid, because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
That's why you stand outside.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan...
All right.
Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Who's your boss?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer.
Sure doesn't seem that way.
Nope.
Okay.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up.
Savage.
You're all right, kid. Go on.
Go, Chloe. Okay. First scene complete. Now let me inside. The little loading bird is being very slow to load. Please, flap your wings faster. Hello? Is this the longest loading screen of all time? There we go.
This is intense!
That looks like a cool place for a game.
Hey, Delia, come.
Cute dog.
Yeah, I could see myself going to gigs here. Don't touch my soul with dirty hands.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Is he gonna like me petting? Let's try.
What's her name?
Delia.
She. And she does! Aww.
She doesn't usually like people.
Well, I guess, yeah. I've just got a...
me neither.
...special way with animals.
Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
Yo!
Damon Merrick again? Who is this guy?
Someone you don't mess with.
Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
That sounds like something that will come in handy later.
Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down any minute.
There's no way that that doesn't become a thing later, right?
Okay, good. $20, baby.
$20? That's robbery. And don't call me baby.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
Let's get creative.
No. Look, we have to set this up. If you don't have $20, beat it.
Can I argue with you? Nope,
still
guess not.
Dick.
No.
Skeevy guys.
Sketch Central.
Yeah, boy.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please.
I'm going to a party tomorrow night. That's going to be fun. I have not had a lot to drink in quite a while.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
There's got to be something with releasing the parking brake, right? It actually is. Okay.
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Bye-bye.
Shit. No. Come on.
It's a hard knock life for you.
Thanks
it's
for playing.
It's a hard knock life
Dick.
For you. Gimme that shirt.
Oh, yeah. Sweet, sweet victory.
Stealing is cool, kids.
That's like $200.
Stealing is ultra omega cool, kids.
Illuminati confirmed.
Holy shit. I'm rich.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Right. Okay. What am I stuck on? Oh. I saw I could look at this. Graffiti it? Oh, yeah. You know I'm going to be tagging everything I can. Evil eye. Nice. Just need to color it in red, like not rusty like that, but like proper blood red. Nice.
300 dock workers laid off, their pensions canceled. God, Prescott's a real tool.
Dear members of the Arcadia Bay Steve Dorr Association, the Prescott Foundation, having recently purchased the Arcadia Bay Marine Corporation as part of a bankruptcy settlement, has decided to eliminate your position. Wow, savage. Along with the positions of all 307 members of your union. Furthermore, the foundation is liquidating all assets of ABMC, including the longshoreman's pension, fuck, which has been granted as payment against credit owed, Jesus. We advise that your employment agreement forbids you from disclosing any company practices or methods of operation, including the details of this workforce reduction. What a motherfucker.
That's totally me in 5 beers.
Totally, yo.
Okay, 3.
Right, can I get in this way? I don't know if I should see what's upstairs first. Let's have a look what's upstairs first. Also, let's have a look what's over here.
No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can.
At all times, in fact.
Classy.
What's it say? Ah. Okay, can't do anything. Oh, that was the door. Yeah, okay. That was the other door. Oh, hey.
Yo, Frank.
Hey.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot from me every month.
Do I remember him from Life is Strange 1?
Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
But I'm taking so long about it, the show will probably be over, but
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
Okay, so, you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
That'll be never then. Oh.
Toss in a dime bag and we'll call it square.
Hey, hey! What are you waving around this kind of money here for? You really don't think before you act, do you?
Nope. So where's my pot?
No more loans. I'm not your fucking piggy bank.
You're a good man, Frank.
No, that's cool.
I'm not. Now beat it, Price. You're cramping my style.
Personally, that the drug life ain't for me, but I'm pretty sure it is for her. I'm just gonna be totally in character. Oh, right, you can't go upstairs.
Those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey.
Cool. Is there anything else to say to him?
She returns.
I'll see you later.
Nope.
Whatever.
Okay. Oh wait, dartboard?
Reminds me of the way I make important life choices.
Scattershot. Indeed. Let's go.
Here we go.
Oh, that's not gonna go down well.
Fuck.
Skeevy dude numero uno. I'm sorry, man. You wanna pick a fight?
You okay?
I'm fine.
Oh, okay.
Relax.
Oh.
You bumped into me.
Oh, no. I mean, the Chloe thing to do.
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
Don't want to.
No. And I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go.
What?
Fine.
Why is it a no-go? Just as I fucked
Maybe
it
I
once.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
And he is the new dialogue with him?
She returns.
Probably not. Oh, yep.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell
he
was.
Is he the one that tagged the wall?
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
Oh.
I see you've heard
Servant
of
him. Servant of the one.
This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Upstairs? Oh. It's not funny if he makes the joke because it's supposed to be a shit joke.
Will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
Then I guess I'll have the view to myself.
Whatever.
Whatever, dude. Wonder how many copyright claims I'll get on this. Because Life is Strange 1 got all the fucking copyright claims. And as the first game I'd ever done on YouTube, that shat me up a bit. Turns out,
yes!
They don't fucking
Finally
matter,
made
it seems.
I can't believe it!
Yeah! They would matter if I, like, actually ran ads or anything, but I'm a tiny channel, so I don't do that. I can leave whenever I want, but why would I want to? This is Chloe's dream. I hope you can hear my voice over this, actually. I'm gonna spill your blood in a second, prick.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
I don't like your face.
Then how about I unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer.
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word.
Wanna bet?
Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Please fall through the floor. Fall through the ride floor. Oh god.
Hey! Dickhead!
Ooh. Get him, girl!
Rachel?
Oh shit! Rachel Amber? Oh, Rachel, I am so sorry. I know your future. And it is not pretty.
Let me go, Frank. Not gonna happen. Calm down. Come on, man. Walk away. Screw this.
Ha. Ah. Love it. Love it. Get in there. Straight to the front. That's what I like to see. I'm giving it the head bop in my chair right now.